Six. Tuning joke since I was 15 and nobody laughs. I don't want to learn a new joke.
Thank you. called causation by correlation. Or was it really?
What do the science books say?
I don't know. But that's, yeah, we accidentally found that those two tunes just, like, snap together. So, yeah. And this next one is called Blue Drag, which is a mix of, wow.
How many of us are playing this? I want to thank Pam and Lee who gave me this banjo.
I need to play it.
Thank you. Thank you.
that's kind of how I got into this music. Not really, but you know. it's how I got into music in general. My great 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 grandfather back on my mom's side was the first professor of music at West Virginia University, and then, you know, we've all been making the same mistake since. So yeah, music kind of runs in my blood. I was thinking about my family when I wrote this song. There's a lot of substance abuse and stuff that's also been in my family. And so, you know, we think about that and we try to write songs that are meaningful. So yeah, here's a tune that doesn't have words, but kind of along those thought lines. Wrote this song, I stole the melody from Bob Dylan, and what do you know, he stole it from like a 200-year-old bird ballad. So, you know, and this song was reflecting on, I heard a story about a man in West Virginia, and the story is a lot like a lot of the people that my cousin know and have grown up around.
Thank you.
The wind is old and still at play, but I must hurry upon my way, for I am running to paradise. Yet never have I wept on a friend to take my fancy like the wind, that nobody can buy or find, and there the king is both asked and
Lucy writes a lot of songs in weird time signatures. This is not an attack. I get them mixed up. So this is the one that's in 11-8. It's not the one that switches from 4-4 to 3-4. That comes later. Okay. But they start on the same chord. And now. Guys, I have great news for you. There's this TED Talk you should watch. Brene Brown talks about vulnerability, and she talks about how sometimes we like to keep our lives tidy, you know? And so we put, like, our relationships in a box, and we put our work in a box, and we put our careers in our school, and, you know, boxes. And that's very tidy, and she says that sometimes the lives worth living are the ones that are kind of messy and open to pain and open to rejection and failure. Which is something I've been thinking about and she used to verbalize for me. This is a song I wrote kind of on that theme. It's in Lydian. Y'all are all Berklee cats, so you know that Lydian is an uncertainty. Moan! Ow! I'm sorry, little Sylvia. But you know, so this is an uncertain song.
tuning room. I could have been doing that while I was yammering, you know? Also, we don't know what time it is, so if we start running over somebody, call her. Because we could go on and on. We have a lot of tunings. I'm trying to deceive the people. Okay. Seemed like he was a pretty fun dude. Hopefully he wasn't like a terrible person or something. But this is called Ebony.
If you know that he was, please let us know after the show.
Yeah, here's Ebony Survive.
Thank you.
to get to tune. So this next tune is, it's not a mashup, it's a set. I learned that word when I started doing, like, the old-time music. yes, this is two songs put together. That's what we're going to play. And so, like, when Lucy and Esther started jamming, she taught me this song called Mirror Hauling, which is a song they dance to in Norway, which is pretty cool. And we'd also been playing this Django theme called Dance to Norwegian, and we were like, Norwegian, Norwegian. They go together, so we mashed them up.
They both did Norwegian dances at some point.
Exactly, yeah, it worked.
Thank you.
We have one more song. This one, Lucy wrote. Guess what? It's also inspired by poetry. Lucy does this really cool thing where she has set a Shelley poem. Eyes over here. No, she set a poem by Percy Best Shelley to music. And she sent it to me over the summer. So, like, she was talking about earlier, she lives in California and I live in Tennessee. So we couldn't practice all summer because of lag on Skype. Instead of Soon Paul's house. We practiced at Soon Paul's house. In upstate New York. Hi, Soon Paul. Thank you for the score. Anyway. So, yes. Most of the summer we did practice together, but she sent me this. And this melody that she had written. And she's like, I'm going to put words to it. I don't know what. And I was like, and so I was kind of coming up with four voicings, and then we got together at like midnight in upstate New York for the first time in 3 months, and just like came together really quickly. So yeah, we're going to live on, we have an album, and we have an EP. Thank you for screeching. yes, there's four songs on it. I'm told that's standard for an EP. It's one of the ways that you stream. We need to make some hard CDs someday, but they have not been made.
What's it called?
Oh yeah, it's called Fast and Loose. We just kinda anyway.
Yeah. That's the last one. Thank you. Jordan